We're tracking TD number 4 out in the Atlantic. We're tracking a little bit of something going on in the Caribbean, plus a whole lot more.
Plus, we have the hot weather here, and there's Hurricane Flossie.
Yeah, we've got lots to talk about, guys. In fact, Flossie's out there in the Pacific. It's been moving toward Hawaii, toward the Big Island. Fortunately, it's going to pass south of there, and it's even weakened somewhat. I just got the latest advisory from the Central Pacific Hurricane update. Let's take a look now at some video. Check that out. Surfers are loving it. Windsurfers out there hitting those waves. Waves going to be up around 10, 15, even 18 feet across parts of Hawaii as that hurricane passes just south. So pretty good news there, although there will still be a flooding and a storm surge threat with that wave action as well. So here's a look at it. You can see on the satellite picture, see that eye, Category 3 hurricane, but weakening somewhat as it passes over some slightly cooler waters. So good news there. 115 on the top winds out there right now. Temperatures for you back home, though, running in the mid to upper 70s from Ocala to the Villages to Orlando. 81 at the Space Center right now, 76 at Daytona Beach where the skies have cleared out a bit. But you can see those high clouds kind of sitting across our skies that trapped in the heat from yesterday. So we're starting out a little warmer, and it's going to be just as hot this afternoon as that sunshine begins to work on those temperatures fairly quickly. 92, 93, 94 over the coastline, 91 around Palm Coast. You get to the inland areas, we're talking 96, 97. Orlando, Claremont, Kissimmee, right around Sanford. I think Ocala up to 95 today. So plenty of heat to go around for everybody. Still associated with a big area of high pressure back toward Colorado in Kansas. We're on the sinking side of that high. It's really heating things on up. Meanwhile, low pressure back over the Gulf, looking a little more organized. I'm going to update on that one in a minute. Here's a look at the far eastern Atlantic, though. First off, because this is TD4 still racing westward at around 21 miles an hour. Very latest coordinates from the National Hurricane Center this morning there for you. Still more than 3,000 miles from Florida, so still a long way out over the Atlantic, but we're watching this closely because right now the winds are at 35 as a depression. However, watch what happens. Tropical storm later today, by early Friday, Category 1 hurricane, possibly a Cat 2 coming up late in the weekend as it's moving in toward the Antilles. Forecast track, certainly not certain at this point. We know it's going to move west for now, but what happens when it gets up toward the Antilles is still a broad range. It may recurve and head out toward the open waters. It may even go on into the Caribbean. So we're just going to have to watch coming up late in the week for the very latest. Meantime, we're watching the Gulf because these thunderstorms here beginning to look a little more impressive, getting some rotation with those. And as that moves west to the northwest, we're not concerned that Florida will be affected by any of that moisture. In fact, we're on the dry side of this, so our rain chance is dropping down. But it looks like this thing should head on in toward the Mexico and South Texas coastline over the next several days. Could be a storm, though. As it does that, we'll keep an eye. Here's your 5-day plus two. Look at the heat. You get the idea. Low rain chances coming up next weekend. We may get a front in here on Saturday that could help us with the rain chances a little bit, but we'll wait and see on that.